Good morning, everybody. So the biceps is the structure which automatically get once rotator cuff tear is there, and we can utilize the collagen from the biceps to increase the healing potential of the cuff in case of some special situations. So I studied about 12 cases of rotator cuff tears. 5 were retracted full thickness tears, 7 bursal side tears. 8 male, 4 females in between 61 to 74 years of age group. And the duration of symptoms were from 18 to 30 months. Clinically, the cuff tests were positive, MRI, and you can see the X-ray shows the cuff tear along with sharp acromial spine. And in some cases, there were also the AC joint arthritis. So total follow-up post-operatively was 11 to 36 months. Here you can see the bursal side tears, the sharp acromial spurs, and in some cases there is AC joint arthritis also. So my indications for using the biceps in rotator cuff are old retracted cuff tears, which are very difficult to bring to the tuberosity, and there will be too much tension on the repair. Bursal side tears of supraspinatus and superficial bursal spraying with a acromial spur and severe shoulder pain. The contraindications are past the lesion and diseased biceps. So I do arthroscopy in lateral decubitus position with the 4 border, posterior, anterior superior, anterolateral, and posterolateral. First I do some coracoplasty, then release the biceps or around, do the bicep stenotomy, then acromioplasty, AC resection, and later on then I use biceps in the cuff repair. So this is one case. First, initially I repaired the subscap, then do the acromioplasty. Here, there you can see a big subacromial bursal tear. Pulled out the biceps into the subacromial space, passed the biceps in that torn hole in the supraspinatus, and then repaired it over it. You can see the intra-articular view. It's like a patch graph. Secondly, this is another case. Here, from the inside, you cannot see anything other than this frayed area. Then I release the biceps some in the rotator interval all around so that it can be easily pulled into the subacromial space. Did acromioplasty, then lateral and clavicle resection, AC joint resection, and then debrided that torn area. I didn't make the tear complete. Passed the anchor and sutures, and one of the sutures is passed through the biceps, and then the biceps is repaired over the acromial side cuff tear. This is another case where there is a massive retracted tear. There is also subscap tear along with the supra infra tear. So initially, after some release, I stitched the biceps to the distal end of the cuff. The loop, using the loop type sutures, and then did the cuff repair so that I get the extra length and there will be a less tension on the repaired cuff. So the postoperatively arm pouch for 6 weeks, icing 7-8 days, and then passive ROM as tolerated after 10th day. Gradually full passive ROM by 6 weeks, and then start the active assisted exercises and active strengthening only after 2 to 2.5 months. So these are some results. 10 patients have excellent function with full ROM. 2 patients developed stiffness and needed some local injection and manipulation. There is no infection and no re-tear. So this is the MRI of one of the patients. You can see the excellent incorporation of the biceps into the cuff with the some thickened collagen area near the insertion. In conclusion, the massive retracted tears, there is too much tension if it is retracted toward the greater tuberosity. The biceps are as an excellent biological bridge autograft. The bursal tears are very painful and causes stiffness. And if we make the bursal tear complete, then that repair will be too much tight, and the postoperatively patient can have pain and stiffness. So in such situation, instead of making it a complete tear, we can use a biceps over that tear as a patch graft. So the MR biceps not only augment but also act as a live patch collagen graft. In the Western world, they are using the bovine patches or some other tissues, but these are yet not available in our country, so we can make use of biceps. And MRI studies shows excellent incorporation of the biceps into the cuff and overall good to excellent result. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Satish. Anybody, any questions or comments?
In bursal side tear, mainly those are because of either the spur from the acromion or the spur from the AC joint, and there is a lot of fraying. The tissue quality of the supraspinatus is very flimsy. In that condition, even after the repair, there is a fear in our mind that there can be a suture cutout or something like that. In that condition, just as an augment, we can put a biceps over that repair.
If there is a small half a centimeter or 1 centimeter retraction from...
No, if it is a full thickness tear with a retraction, then I won't use a bicep, just a simple
repair. Let me
complete
my question, please. Okay. I'm just taking his question forward.
Okay.
On a small bursal sided tear, where the articular sided is intact,
yes,
you're putting a graft. In a small, just 1 centimeter retraction from the GT,
yes,
we just repair it straight away, right?
Yes.
And the biceps width is only 1 centimeter, less than 1 centimeter.
Yes.
Then why do you need a patch graft for a only partial sided bursal tear? We don't use a patch graft for a small one sided full thickness tear, do we?
No.
Then why do we need it for bursal sided?
Because the bursal side tear, we are not making it complete, and we are repairing it partially. So there are high chances that it can re-tear or go into the complete tear. So we are just putting a extra collagen over that repair so that it will act as a live graft.
So he's just reinforcing the
just
partial
reinforcing
tear.
That repair.
I thought about a couple of questions, but first has been taken. The second one was, I think couple of times you mentioned AC joint excision. So you are doing AC joint excision in each and every
one? No, not each. Whenever there is a AC joint arthritis or there is a spur from the AC joint.
And approximately what percentage of your cuff tears, as in cuff repairs, are you putting the biceps tendon in? Because if you're putting bursal sided ones, you're putting bursal fibrillations, as in frames, not fibrillations, and you're putting in big full thickness tears.
I am using
a high percentage.
I am using it on the bursal fraying and a bursal full thickness hole like tear. Or if it is a massive retracted tear, which I cannot bring it easily toward the GT.
So virtually, that was my question.
The tear which are simple, which can be easily repaired, I am not using biceps.
Okay.
Right, let's get it this way. There's a lot of questions about the bursal tear, but I should think what you're trying to say is, most of the times you use it for massive tears.
Yes.
Where the bursal tear is an incidental thing that you're trying.
Incidental. Now just as a patch graft.
Just educate me, are there any literature supporting using...
Yes, there are some articles from Youngalry and
yes, there
Professor
are a couple of articles.
Yes.
But you did it all arthroscopic, right?
Yes.
And these are retracted tears to the level of glenoid.
Yes.
And then you split it and
the
tendon...
No, I release it from the top, then I release it on the capsular side.
Yes.
So whatever I can bring it just up to the articular surface. Then along that area, I stitch first the biceps toward that area and then bring it.
So it is not covering the entire anteroposterior diameter, the extent of the tear? Because
no, it won't cover.
It is just like acting like a sling
pulling
the...
about mid portion of the tear.
So it is basically a check rein which is pulling the retracted edge. It is not actually acting as a patch graft.
It's acting as a patch graft. It will reduce the tension on that tear, because otherwise you won't bring that tear up to the tuberosity. The biceps will act as a patch in between the tear, the supraspinal, the tear and the greater tuberosity.
So in my mind, there are two things. Either there is a traction suture-like thing which is pulling the retracted edge towards the GT. That is one type where it can work.
Yes.
Other is patch graft, as you are saying it, where the patch covers the defect between the retracted edge and the glenoid.
Yes.
And GT. Now, what are you using it as a patch or a traction suture?
Patch. Because initially I repaired the biceps to the
cuff. Biceps is attached at its glenoid part. You're detaching it below. This section that is the loose, that is the free end, which is about an inch and a half, you take that cut in and then fix it as close to the GT.
Yes.
That acts as a part to reinforce the torn part.
Yes.
So you don't detach the biceps from glenoid?
Initially, I don't detach.
Later on, you do.
Later on.
So you make, rather than going like this, you make it anteroposterior.
Yes.
Okay, so that biceps is fixed as a patch anteriorly, and then you detach it from glenoid, fix it posteriorly, so it becomes a kind of a bridge on the GT to which the tendon is repaired. You got the technique? Then it's like a patch graft. Though it is only 1 centimeter addition.
The edge is retracted towards the glenoid.
But it is adding to 1 centimeter collagen, you can say, at the most. Okay.